basically try to understand the difference. First of all, jihad is duty of government. They can decide better that this time should we attack other nation or not. They have to decide, because they are having for this purpose trained army, as he told. It's good. And then they knew the international situation, that after this fight, what kind of consequences they have to face. First, they have to decide about it, and then they will follow the rules of jihad, as I told now. If they have decided, then first of all, they will announce it, they will break their treaties, they will bring back their ambassadors, all these things will be done, then the fight will be started. One thing. Now, why not individual and groups? They are led by some other powers towards terrorism. How? Mostly it happened in near past and even nowadays, that when the groups, they started such kind of movement, the first thing is this, according to my analysis, and I have support for my analysis, supporting material for this. For example, nowadays, in near past, there was a name Daesh. Do you know about it? Okay, I'm going to tell about it. Some people in Iraq, they started fighting against America, because America captured Iraq before 10-15 years ago. There is long history. Before, there was the fight between Kuwait and Iraq. America involved, he attacked Iraq, he occupied Iraq. Although there were Iraqi Muslims in government, but they were ruled by America. So that group, some people, they started their jihad in Iraq against America, and within no time, they occupied a big area of Iraq. Their leader's name was Abu Bakr Baghdadi. So, in the leadership of Baghdadi, they were beard, having amama, and Islamic, all things, five-time prayer, all these things, Islamic. And very quickly, they became very successful. They occupied some area of Iraq. And then they proceeded and they occupied some area of Syria. For example, this Venn diagram, you may extend it. Here they established their government. Some area from Iraq, some from Syria. And this is called Dawlatul Islamiya fil Iraq wa Sham. This is Daesh. In English, ISIS. Islamic State of Syria and Iraq. Mean Islamic State of Syria and Iraq and Syria. ISIS. So in start they were not called ISIS, it was a group. When they captured this area, they renowned as ISIS, and Abu Bakr Baghdadi himself declared that I am Caliph of Muslim, I am the only Muslim state on the world, you should follow me. All of them, all the Muslims, they should follow me, because all other countries, they are not Islamic countries in the true sense of Khilafah, Caliphate. So it was his version. So let me complete it. Now within no time they did this. How? Now I'm going to... Basically, they were sponsored by CIA, American Intelligence Agency, and they became a threat for many other people, there was hidden agenda of America. Why? Now I'm going to support it, supporting material. America is occupying Iraq, and a group coming from some other areas, and most of the people in ISIS were from England, France, and some other European countries, and they were highly skilled, educated persons. And those people, not professional army, but within no time they captured this area from Iraq, this from here. Was America not able to stop them? Were other powers not able to stop them over there? How they become succeeded? Because America gave them space to establish over there, and they established. And what they were doing there? They were drilling oil mine from Iraq, Syria, and they were selling that oil in international market. Then they were purchasing weapons, helicopters, tanks from international market and fighting inside Iraq and Syria. How is it possible? When Pakistan, he experimented about the nuclear weapons in 1999 or 97, America imposed sanctions on Pakistan. For 5 years, those sanctions Pakistan has to face. And even nowadays on Iran, there are sanctions. Sanctions mean you cannot sell your goods in international market. How Daesh was able to sell their oil in international market? If they were against America and these powers, basically, what was the agenda? America sponsored them to destabilize Muslim countries in Gulf. And it happened because there was a meeting in Pentagon. Now it is disclosed. An official of CIA, he was called by Obama. Obama said him, "I don't want Assad more, Assad the ruler of Syria." And that official said, "Obama, how is it possible?" He said, "No, I need it. I will do this." So this was a kind of, now I'm not going to the all details. Obama, American president.
That time Obama was the president. Now what do you think? Obama is all nice,
right? President made plan through his intelligence agency and all these things.
Guys, Clinton, Obama, they are all they are killing people and they are saying that we are terrorists.
Okay, so come to the point. Because it was their agenda to remain in Gulf with their armies. Why? What do they do? Their game. What is the game? First of all, they create unrest in different countries, mean America type. First of all, they create unrest in some countries, then they send their army over there to handle that unrest. By this way, they make their presence over there legal, then they started taking money from our countries. We are here to protect you, otherwise these people will kill you. That's why pay us and accept us. Recently, if you know, what is the name of Pagal man. Donald Trump. He said, "Oh, Mr. Salman, I love you.
Yeah, I know that.
But you cannot survive with us for 1 week. We protect you, so pay us."
He said that.
This is on record. And we people mean we Muslim, not only Salman. We all people, the Muslims. We have no courage to say him a single word, that, "Oh madman, what are you doing?"
And then so,
now, here, the next question in front of you, which I put 7-6 years before in front of a person, and he made me unfriend from Facebook. So, what was my question and still, which shows that Daesh was sponsored by CIA Israel. What is the question? At that time, that person belonged to Taliban and he was promoting Daesh, Taliban, this and this. I raised the question that was this, that Daesh is making jihad. They are fighting in Iraq, which is Islamic country. They are fighting in Syria, killing innocent people over there, that is Islamic country. I don't believe in Sunni and Shia, I am Muslim only. And they are also, they send some suicider in Saudi Arabia. There is a city near Dammam. There was two or three suicide attacks. And even some attacks were made in Karachi and in Afghanistan. I asked, this is Iraq, this is Syria, this is Daesh, and here is Israel. Why the people directly or indirectly not attacking Israel? They are only attacking in Muslim countries, creating unrest over there, killing Sunni, Shia, this and this. So Jews are better than Sunni, or Jews are better than Shia. Why they are not attacking Israel, which is our the core enemy? And he made me unfriend. And today I am asking this question to international community, America, UNO, vagaira, vagaira. They should give this answer. That if they were Mujahideen, they were doing jihad. So jihad is against non-Muslim, not against Muslims. This is the difference between jihad and terrorism. So when any group will start jihad, if they are sincere, they will be hijacked by some international power. But mostly what I have observed, their leaders of the groups, they were the agents of international powers. But common people, you and me, we have been fighting for the sake of God, but the leaders, they were the agents. That's why the results are negative, not positive. And if you see Taliban, Daesh, all these people, very common but thought-provoking question, they have done their all struggle inside Muslim countries. Muslims were killed, masjids, they were bombarded, civil community, Pakistan army or the other Muslim armies, they were attacked. Why not the international non-Muslim people, they were attacked? It means they people, this kind of jihad, they people were sponsored by non-Muslim powers. They were exploited on the name of religion, and they did this, and what was their objective, and they achieved. Objective was this, to make controversial jihad, and it has become. So now it is very difficult to differentiate between jihad and terrorism. If someone is sincere, like me people, they are considered terrorists because they are having beard, they are wearing shalwar kameez, they are wearing topi, cap. So they are in generally by their posture, they are considered terrorists. And this is a great game. So I'm repeating, difference between jihad and terrorism. Jihad should be done by government. If government is not doing, they are sinful, not you, not me. When they need me, they are asking, okay, our army is fighting, but now the fight has spread into the streets of cities. Okay, common people, come on and fight. Then we should fight. Otherwise, we paying our armies. They are for this purpose, they are trained, they should fight. If they are not fighting, they are sinful. But me, I am not responsible for that. I am responsible for my sisters, my daughters at my home. At international level, they should decide. And keep in mind, as I gave you two examples, the other example of Taliban in Pakistan, not in Afghanistan. About Afghanistan, I am clear, they are doing right. I know my voice is being recorded by American satellites. I have faced the situation in Pakistan also. I don't care about it. But what is the right? What is the correct? And I hope that my students, they will speak truth. You are here.
Sir, how
will
you overcome this? Because you are the leader of the
Yes. As in general, I tell you, this time I'm telling you, you are the people not responsible for such kind of conflict. But you should speak truth at house, at school, at national level, at international level. As I'm telling you, and this is the fact, I'm writing a thesis about it. I want to tell the world that you are hypocrite people. You are blaming on Islam and you are doing all these things by yourself. What is the fault of innocent people? If I am joining any group, I am sincere for Islam. I am giving my life. Inshallah, I will be shaheed. But this is my misconception. I should not join any group. I should stand with Muslim majority. That is my government. Government, whether it is right or wrong, I should change my government and I should change my policies. I should not go there with some of my friends and agenda is from CIA or Russia or India and I am giving my life. For what purpose? So this is basic difference.